Okay, then, so as Ananda says, Brahmi Bhutasya Vidushaya Svatantrayadivata, that is Svatantra with reference to the creation. So by calling him Vashi and Ishanaha and Adhipatihi, what is meant is that he is free from any influence or impact of the whole universe. So, like Swami Dayananda describing the conversation between these two mad people who happen to meet at a street corner in the evening, each one with his own wealth and collection of the day. So, what is your name? Jahan Khan. My Jahan Khan. You know? So, I am the lord of the whole Jahan. Or Jahan Khan, so means, I think Swami's understanding is that I can eat the whole universe, you know. What is your name? Tujhe Khan, you know. So, that is why I am the lord of you. That is it. That is enough to, that's the freedom, that's all. After all, what is freedom? Freedom is not something that is associated with anything outside of you anyway. Freedom is nothing but the state of mind. And therefore, this person enjoys that freedom. Outwardly he may be imprisoned also. And therefore, as far as outward conditions are concerned, he may not be free at all. And still a person can be free. And that freedom has to be just discovered. That freedom cannot be given by anybody. It is something that one has to discover oneself. Other freedom can be given. He can be released from the prison. He can be made an adhipati and vashi and whatever it is, you know. And still the person can be bound. And thus he may be sitting in the highest seat and still may feel completely bound. He may be sitting on the floor and may feel free also. And therefore, freedom naturally has nothing to do with the external entrapments or external environment. It has only to do with how one feels or how one sees oneself. That feeling comes only from seeing, not the feeling of this mad person who feels he is free. The wise person sees himself to be free. That is svatantryadivat. That is free as far as his relationship with the world is concerned, that he enjoys total freedom. But similarly also, dharma and adharma, in India of course, in the Vedic culture, these are big complexes of dharma and adharma, of doing that which is right and avoiding that which is wrong. Of course, it is there in every society, but very much pronounced in the Vedic society. So very conscious about what they do, very conscious about karma. Then you must make sure that what you do is right. And you are alert in avoiding that which is not right. So this society has been extremely conscious about it, about dharma. And therefore a person, does he now anymore retain this complex that I must, wait a minute, I must be alert to make sure that what I do is right and make sure that I avoid what is not right? I must do what is becoming of me and must avoid that which is not becoming of me? That alertness or self-deliberation is not required. In short, spontaneously does that which is right and doesn't do that which is wrong. Spontaneously, he is right because identified with that which is right. He is identified with that which is beyond right and wrong or which is absolutely right. Inasmuch as truth is not opposed to, this is the truth which is not opposed to falsehood. This truth that we are talking about is that which transcends the idea of true and false. If I am identified with the truth that is opposed to false, then I must be alert in making sure that I do not in some way lose my truth. But if I am identified with the truth that is not opposed to anything, then I can never be wrong, because this truth is not opposed to falsehood. Tamasah parastat. So this is the light of consciousness that is beyond the darkness, which means what? Not opposed to darkness. Illumining the very darkness. And so this is the truth that illumines both the true and false. So both true and false are at the level of vyavahara. And that is relevant as long as one is identified with the upadhi, or there is a sense of kartrutvam. Of course there is something that is true and false. But then he is identified with the truth that is beyond the idea of false and true. Uve satya anurte tyaktva yena tejasi. Tatyaja. And that is how this is a greater freedom for the Vedic person. For the person growing in Vedic culture, this dharma-dharma-adi, dharma-dharma-asparshitvapi, that he is not in any way touched by dharma and dharma, is a more important phalam. Namam karmani limpandi apa or na kartrutvam na karmani lokasya srujati prabhu. And so no kartrutvam, no karaitrutvam. And so Ananda Giri, adhisthanadi kartrutvad vidushopi laukikavad dharmadi sambandhitvam syadidi shankate. Adhishthanadi kartrutvad. Because you said earlier, sarvasya vashi, sarvasya ishanaha, sarvasya adhipatihi. And therefore he is the controller of all, he is the lord of all, he is the ruler of all. And therefore he is ruling everybody, he is controlling everybody. So adhishthanadi kartrutvad. Because they are all the, in fact, kartruvachaka words are there, you know. Vashim is the one who controls. Ishana is the one who lords. Adhipati is the one who rules. That means he rules and he controls and lords everybody. That means he is a karta, he is an agent of this kind of actions. Adhisthanada kartratvat vidushopi laukika laukikavat dharmadi sambandhitvam syat. And just as we also in our vyavahara control somebody, rule somebody, whatever it is, and how we are stuck with the consequences, similarly also, when he is ruling the whole universe, he must be stuck with the consequences of dharma and adharma. Idi shankate. So to say that he is sarvasya vashi, sarvasya ishanaha, sarvasya adhipatihi, and then to say, sana sadhana karmana bhuyan, no eva asadhana kaniyan, these two appear to be contradictory. Because vashi, ishanaha, adhipatihi, all of these are the words that denote some kind of an action, denotes an agent of action. So being an agent of action on one hand, and then to say that not being affected by action on the other hand, appears to be contradictory. And so that contradiction, Vashyakara wants to resolve. That is why this shanka is there. Iti shankate. This shanka is although as though raised by Vashyakara himself in order to clarify. Says Vashya, sarvohi adhisthana palanade kurvanna paranugraha pida kritena dharma dharma khena yujyate asyevato katham tadabhava ide. Anyway, so sarohi, everyone, adhisthana palanadi. So when protect somebody by being adhisthata, being svatantra. So when you protect somebody or when you support somebody or provide for somebody, being independent, adhisthana palanadi kurvan, then what happens? Para anugraha pida krutena. When you rule over everybody, others, when you lord over others, when you control others, then it's going to happen that you have to, so para anugraha and pida, sometimes you appear to be favoring somebody, sometimes you appear to be punishing somebody. Naturally a king has to do that. So anugraha and pida, sometimes you have to punish them. If you find that they are going off the track, you have to keep them on the track. And those people who are on the track have to be encouraged also. And so this is the common thing, like karma phala data also. So one who dispenses of the result of action, you find him sometimes favoring people by giving them things that are agreeable, sometimes punishing the people by subjecting them to conditions which are painful. So similarly also, if this person is called Vashi and Ishana and so forth, then para anugraha pida kritena dharma dharma khena. So when you make someone happy, that's called dharma. When you inflict pain upon somebody, that's called dharma. And therefore, he will wind up in incurring what we call punya and papa. ధర్మాధర్మాఖ్యను యుజ్యతే, సర్వో హి యుజ్యతే. ఎవ్రీబడి ఎవ్రీబడి యూజ్ ఇన్ పొజిషన్ టు డూ, వీ నో దాట్ దట్ పర్సన్ గెట్ స్టక్ విత్ ద కాన్సిక్వెన్సెస్ ఆఫ్ వాట్ ఇట్ డస్. అస్సేవ తు కథం తదభావ ఇది. Then how come this wise person, even though he is Vashi and Ishana and Adhipati, and still he is free from this effect of Punya Papa, how come? So rather than explaining it in this Vedanta, Bhashyakara gives further explanation of Sarveshwara, etc. You know? So anyway, Bhashyakara Uchyate Yasmat Eshaha. So paratantratvam upadhi. Sorry, that we should read. Anandagiri said, paratantratvam upadhi di pariharde. Upadhi ukta anumane. This is anumanam. Sarvohi. This is the rule. Rule is that, so para anugraha pida akratena dharma dharma akhyana yujyade. This is the rule. That means everybody, whoever it is, that inflicts pain and pleasure to the people must be stuck with the consequences, answerable, you know, for the action that the person performs. How come this person appears to be free? Except that there, paratantratvam upadhihi. So this is applicable to whom? That if I favor somebody, then I will be stuck with the consequences, and if I punish somebody, then again I will be stuck with is for whom? For the one who has paratantratvam upadhihi. So this is a conditional. Anumanam is there. Upta anumanam. So wherever para anugraha and pida is there must be then the affection by dharma dharma. So where will that this rule applicable? This is not a universal rule. This is a rule with a condition. So upadhi is called condition. Paratantratvam upadhihi. So this rule is conditional. That where paratantratvam is, paratantratvam, when you are controlled by others, so when that independence is not there, when the freedom is not there, then I get struck by good and bad things that I do because I am answerable. Let us say that even the Prime Minister, you know, he is a Ishanahan and he is a Vashi and he is a Adhipati and he is still paratantra, he is still answerable to Parliament or he is still answerable to Judiciary, and therefore if he does something which goes against the constitution, is answerable. Why is it so? Paratantratvat. He doesn't have the total freedom because he is answerable to the people by way of parliament, or he is answerable to law by way of the court. Therefore, no ruler is there at this time. But suppose you are a sovereign, you are the queen of England, or you are the, you know, the king or whatever, then you are the sovereign. You are not answerable to anybody. If you were the sovereign anyway, the queen may have a hard time, you know, getting away with things, but then that is called a sovereign who is not answerable to anybody. So, in short, this rule that you must be answerable to whatever actions you perform is applicable only where you are not totally free. So, paratantratvam upadhihi parihati uchyate iti. So Bhashyakara says, Uchyate Yasmat Eshah Sarveshwarasan Karmanopi Ishitum Bhavati Eva Shilamasya Tasmat Na Karmana Sambadhyate. This is now. So here the rule that you stated is not applicable here, because the rule that you stated is applicable only under certain conditions. Yasmat Eshah. See, the one that we are talking about, this one is Sarveshwara. He is a Lord. He is Ishvara, the Lord of all. Sarveshwara. He sees, he lords everybody. Therefore, Karmanopi Ishitam Shilam Bhavati Eva. Therefore, when he lords over everybody, he also lords over karma. So if I lord of everybody, but still I am answerable to the law of the land, then I am not free. I may be the Prime Minister and I am the lord of everybody, but still I am required to function according to the law, then I am not free. But suppose I was not answerable to anybody, then of course, then I am the master of the law also. Here, Lord is the one who is the master of the law also. So everybody who is under his control, the answer is, he is subject to the law. But he, being the Ishvara, Sarveshvara, that Sarva, he is the Lord of all, that all also includes the law. The laws are also of his making, but sometimes when you make the law, then you are supposed to abide by the law also. When you make a law, everybody must come here at 8 o'clock, you know, and must be together at the end, then you also must come. That is how it works. But here, but not necessarily, you say that, no entry without permission. So that's the law, but that is not applicable to you. You don't have to seek anybody's permission because this is a law made by you. Depends upon what kind of a condition or what kind of a position you enjoy. He is Sarveshvara San, because he is the Lord of all. Therefore, Karmanopi, Ishitum Bhavati, Eva Shilamasya. Shilam means the very nature. And therefore, it becomes his nature to lord over the karma also, lord over the law also. Tasmat na karmana sambadhyate. And therefore, the one is answerable to the actions performed by oneself, provided one is answerable to the law. And here he is the lord of the law also, and therefore he remains unaffected by whatever he does. Apparently here a license is given to do whatever he wants, because he is the lord of the law also. But again, as we said, the law, he is not only lord of the law, he is the very self of the law. That being the case, he cannot in any way go against the law anyway. Ultimately, gold cannot go against the ornament. I mean, gold can choose whatever shape and the form the ornament is there, and still gold cannot in any way go against it, cannot militate against it. The gold will remain gold regardless of what form the shape is, and similarly also, the Lord will remain perfect regardless of what shape and form he comes in. And therefore, he being perfect, there cannot be anything wrong there. So, paratantratum upadhi, similarly, sarvadipatyarahityam cha upadhi. And also the law, that the rule that is stated, that one is answerable to what one does, is also conditional. In what sense? Sarva adhipatyara, sarva adhipatyarahityam. So when one is not sarva adhipatihi, when one is not the ruler of all, then this happens. So Mahashekara says, kincha esha bhutadipatihi brahmadistamba paryantanam bhutanam adipatihi iti uktartham padam. Appears that this is all a collection of various, you know, statements from different places in Upanishad anyway, because this is Esha Sarveshwar, Esha Bhutadipati, Esha Bhutapala comes from different place. Esha Sarvasya Vashi Ishanaha Adhipatihi, you know. So they're not significant different from each other anyway. But anyway, Esha Futnanuru Pratyagatma, Esha Pratyagatma, or Brahmi Bhuta Vijnanayatma, you can say Vijnanaya Bhutadipatihi. So he's the very ruler of all the beings. Brahmadistama paryantanam bhutanam adhipatihi, the ruler, so adhishthaya palaita, not only provider, but independent, being independent and provider. Iti uktartham padam, so this word has already been explained. Therefore, if he was not adhipati, if he was not the ruler, then also he would have been subject to the law of karma. In short, this person becomes free from the effect of law of karma also. That's all. Because he is no kartratva, therefore. In case of Ishvara, because he is the lord of the karma also, therefore he is free from the control of the law. And the wise person also is free because he is free from the sense of kartatva. But all of these can apply in a primary sense to Ishvara. All these visheshanas, where Bhashyakara says how he is not affected. Then sarva lokapalatva hetim cha upadhi. And that you are the protector. If you are not the protector of all, then you cannot be the ruler of all. If you cannot be the ruler of all, then you cannot be the lord of all. That's all. So he is the lord of all because he is the ruler of all. He is ruler of all because he is protector. So he's not a ruler who just rules everybody simply by his weapons, but because he's provider, he's protector. He tends to, you know, he takes care. That's the reason why he naturally gains the position of being ruler, and therefore he's a lord. Isha bhutanam teshameva palaita rakshita. Teshameva brahmadistama paryantanam palaita satta spurti pradanena. See, the protector. Again, Ishvara is the protector in the primary sense. By virtue of the upadhi, the wise person is protector only in the sense of knowledge. Satta spurti pradanena. So how do you actually support them? Supporting by providing the needs, or supporting in a primary sense like the clay supports the pot. So pot can be supported two ways. The table supports the pot. So keeps the pot, you know, in the proper position, keep it safe and secure and provides the needs. But the clay also supports the pot by giving the very being to the pot. So we can say that Ishvara supports everybody, protects everybody by providing the needs. While Brahma, the wise person, protects them all by giving them the very satta and the sphurti, by giving them the very existence. Satta, sometimes that's why Mahatma says, "Hum to Brahma se bhi bade hai, Ishvara se bhi bade hai." Ishvara is what he is because of his upadhi. But I am what I am without the upadhi also, you know. So that way satta sphurti pradanena palaita. How come only here it is said, everywhere it is applicable? After all, whether it is Sarveshwara, Bhutadipati, everywhere. He is only by Satta Swati Pradanena. So by virtue of his being Satta and the Sphurti, then he can be called Sarveshwara and Bhutadipati. Not only Palaita. But anyway, so Esha Bhutanam, Teshameva, Brahmadistam Pariyantanam, Palaita, Satta Swati Pradanena, Palaita, Rakshita. He is a protector, the support of them all, by providing their the very satta and the sphurti. Sarva anadharatvam cha upadhi. So all of these beautiful words are only reduced to explaining how he is not affected by karma. That's all, you know. So sometimes, anyway, sarva anadharatvam cha upadhi. And also, if you if you are not the adhara of everybody, then also this limitation can apply to you. So that limitation does not apply to him because he is the adhara of everybody. Alright, so palaita is one, then adhara is another one. So esha, the next one is explained. Esha setuhu vidharanaha esham lokanam asambhedaya iti. Eshah Setuhu. It is a setu, it is an embankment which contains the body of water. That is a bank, contains the body of water. What is setu? It is a bank. Also, what is a barrage which also contains the body of water on one side? You can see the dam also, which also keeps the body of water on one side. But Setuhu, also embankment, or it also means a bridge, or it also means a bank. So, esha setuhu, footnote 5, setuhu iti, seturo setuhu, like a bank, or like a barrage, you know. Taduktam vartike, yathodaka pravahasya, setu vidhanastatha, saroloka vivasthanam, setu saparameshvara iti. Yatha udaka pravahasya setu vidharanah tatha. So just as udaka pravahasya फॉर द फ्लो ऑफ द वाटर सेतु विधरण तथा सेतु हो सेतुर आई डोंट नो सो एनी वे विधरण मीन्स बाउंड्री सो हाउ देयर इज अ सेतु विधरण सो हाउ द बैंक और एम्बैंकमेंट बिकम्स अ बाउंड्री फॉर द फ्लोइंग वाटर सो वाटर इज प्रिवेंटेड फ्रॉम फ्लोइंग सो व्हेन यू मेक अ सेतु लाइक सेतु बंध सो व्हेन यू मेक द बैंक और द बराज देन यू प्रिवेंट द वाटर फ्रॉम फ्लोइंग सो यदा उदक प्रवास सो सेतु यथा उदक प्रवास विधरण सो हाउ द सेतु ऑफ द बैंक बिकम्स ए विधरण बाउंड्री फॉर द फ्लोइंग वाटर सर्वलोक व्यवस्थानां सेतु सह परमेश्वर है सिमिलरली ऑल्सो दैट परमेश्वर इज द सेतु बिकम्स अ बाउंड्री एम्बैंकमेंट सो वन दैट मेंटेन्स ऑल द मर्यादा सो वन दैट मेंटेन्स ऑल द बाउंड्रीज ऑफ एवरीबॉडी सर्वलोक व्यवस्थानां इन द व्यवस्था इन द वेरी द मैनेजमेंट और द कंट्रोल ऑफ द एंटायर क्रिएशन एवरीबॉडी इज कैप्ट इन दैट प्लेस दैट एवरीबॉडी इज कैप्ट इन देयर ओन बाउंड्री and nobody is allowed to transgress their boundaries so that is the setu here so Vashyagara says kim vishishtah iti aha vidharanah varanashramadi vyavasthayah vidharaita setu who means a bank or embankment किम विशिष्ट है सेतु सो वॉट कैंड ऑफ द सेतु ही इज इति आह विधरण सेतु विधरण विधरण ऑल्सो मीन्स बाउंड्री एषाम लोकानाम असंभेदाय एंड दस कीपिंग सो विच प्रिवेंट्स ऑल द भेद संभेद असंभेद सो इट एक्चुअली प्रिवेंट्स ऑल द लोकास फ्रॉम बीइंग मिक्स्ड अप विद ईच अदर ही कीप्स ऑल द लोकास एवरीथिंग apart from each other. He keeps everything distinct from each other, that means within their own boundary. So he maintains the boundary for everything. So varnashramadi vyavasthayaha vidharaita. He is the one who is vidharaita. So one who is a supporter of, or the boundary rather, of all the varna ashram vyavastha. Adina bhuradi loka graha. Wow. So varnashramadi and bhuhu bhuvaha suvaha. Earth is maintained where it is, heaven is maintained where it is, intermediate world where it is, everybody is Surya, Chandra, all of them are maintained where they are, the time and space maintained where they are, and time also keeps on changing according to a certain pattern. Everything follows the predetermined pattern, and nothing has the freedom to transgress that pattern. So that is called the boundary in that sense. वर्णाश्रमादि व्यवस्थायाः मर्यादायाः हि मेंटेन्स मर्यादा मर्यादा वर्ण एंड आश्रम ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्य शूद्र ब्रह्मचर्य गृहस्थ वानप्रस्थ संन्यास ऑल दिस मर्यादा आर इज बीइंग मेंटेन्ड कथम विधारयितृत्वमिति आशंक्याः In what manner? How does he maintain these boundaries or the maryada? Then it is explained tadahayati. Tadah esham bhuradinam brahmalokantanam lokanam asambhedaya asambhinna maryadayai So Shruti herself says, how does he become the vidharana? How does he become the boundary? Esham tadaha. Shruti herself says, esham meaning bhuradinam. That is why varanashramadi, the adi also should include the lokas. That footnote says, esham bhuradinam lokanam brahma lokantanam beginning from bhuhu all the way up to brahma loka lokanam asambhedaya. Footnote number 8, asambhedayati. Tathach asambhedakatvena vidharayitrattvam iti bhavah. So he prevents all these lokas from being mixed up with each other. Asambhedaya maintains the separation, maintains their distinct nature and distinct separation. Otherwise, today it is Bhuloka and tomorrow it changes and becomes Bhuvaloka and someday it becomes Suvaloka and stuff like that. Doesn't happen. Today it is Prithvi and tomorrow the moon changes, becomes moon, you know. And then it becomes Mars. That doesn't happen. Moon is moon and Mars is Mars and Earth is Earth. And everything is what it is. That's all. In case we find them changing, that also only happens according to the law. Or nobody has in freedom to change the way they want. If something is found to change, that rule must be there. What we call chamatkaras, what we call the miracles, of course are those which we cannot understand and therefore we can't explain them also. And so we think that this is something out of the law. But we have to accept that some law must be there about which we are, with which we are not familiar. But ideally, as far as the Vedantins are concerned, nothing can ever happen that will be outside the law. Nahi svabhava bhavana vyavarte prakrute anyatha bhava na kathanchit bhavishyati. One's nature can never change. This is, they are very firm about it. I don't know why should they maintain that kind of thing, but they do. That thing's nature cannot change. If it changes, then you have to understand the nature properly, that's all. But anyway, as far as Vedantins are concerned, the true nature is Brahma anyway. And therefore, until then all the changes can take place, but one can never give up one's Brahmatvam. Never. That's the true nature. Other is just Upadhika. And the other is all Vesha. The Vesha can change. But the Vyavahara also, that things cannot change their nature, otherwise there will be no Vyavastha at all. If anything had the freedom to change by itself, or if anybody had the freedom to change the nature, then also there cannot be Vyavastha. Because they are wedded to law of karma. Fairness. Law of karma is what? Nothing but fairness. And therefore, if by your without deserving, you still get something, then it is not fair. And so even if somebody does Shakti path, you know, and then therefore you become endowed with Shakti and things like that, they would have a hard time accepting even the grace, ultimately. Because how can you get something without having worked for it? Then there is no Vyavastha. That means there is some Ishvara here who can distribute grace like that. Ishvara also doesn't have the freedom to distribute grace, and bhaktas don't like that. So what do you mean Ishvara does not have the freedom? How can you call him Ishvara? If God cannot favor somebody as he wills, then what's the use of calling him God? But these fellows say that God also cannot favor somebody unless some reason is there. Then why do you call him God? Then God also gets controlled by law of karma. So God also doesn't have freedom to act outside the boundary of law. Then you can't call him God. Therefore it is said here that he is Sarveshwara, Ishwara of the law of karma also. And therefore, so this is the view of the bhaktas, devotees, that he alone is called God who has the freedom to favor. If he doesn't have the freedom, what's the use of going to him? I will do what I have to do, that's all. I don't need God. I know that dharma will give rest to this and dharma will give rest to that, that's okay. If God doesn't have freedom to give more than that, why should I approach him? Why should I appeal to him? Why should Draupadi appeal, you know, to God? If the law is going to prevail ultimately, what's the use of calling him? But you call him because the law, you want to transgress that law. So he can come and he can cut off the head of that crocodile and save the elephant. Or he can come and appear in the form of the garments, or the clothes, or the sari, whatever. And that is how the scheme of Dushyasana cannot work. So if this doesn't happen, there will be no bhakti at all. If God also follows and watches everything and says, well, it's up to you. You do good and you can get. Thank you. We don't need you. And so anyway, this is Lord of Nayayika is the one who follows Nyaya. So, ye Bhagavan ko Nyayadish nahi hai. Yadi Nyayadish hoga to unke paas jane se kya fayda hai? Bhagavan Nyayadish nahi hai. So, Bhagavan is the freedom to favor the devotees. Samoham sarabhoteshu namedveshyo sinapriya. To, theek hai. But ye bhajanti maam bhaktya maite teshu chapyam. Look at the Mahatma the bhakti. That samam api vishamam karoti. So one is sama, Bhagavan is sama, equal, also is made unequal. Bhakti makes him unequal. That's what Vartikara said, you know, that how the children also control their mother. Similarly also, So you can say that this one is controlled by everybody. Anyway, so these are all the debates going on. The idea is that whether it is tatpada pradhanyam or tvampada pradhanyam, when tatpada pradhanyam is there, when your sadhana is all centered upon, being dependent upon God, then God cannot be merely a nyayadisha. He has to be something more than that. A mother cannot be merely nyayadisha. Mother has to have something more. In love, all the nyaya goes away. That's called love. Otherwise, what's the use of love? Even I love you, but still, you know, this is it. This is your place, and that is that. That's okay. What sort of love is that? And therefore, in love, all of these things have to go away. So that is why bhakti becomes pradhana. And therefore, tatpada, Ishvara becomes pradhana. I am the sharanagati becomes pradhana. You take care of me. Prapatti, I catch hold of your feet. You take care of me. I am sadhimam tvam prapannam. And therefore, you teach me, I am totally now at your disposal. So one places oneself at the disposal of Lord. And then, it becomes then, teshami anukampartham, aham agnyanajam tama, an anukampa is created in him, then I must do something for him, you know. And so, that is how he reveals himself to him. So this is the tatpada pradhanya. Basically, bhakti means this. Bhakti means where the tatpada pradhanyam is there. Where it is all done by the grace of God. Oh, this is the approach that the devotee has. Yoga means tvampada pradhanyam. Everything is done by sankalpa, you know. And by my sankalpa, I stop all the thoughts and everything. By my power. Vedantins claim to have the strike a balance between both of them, tvam and tat. But basically, they are the tvampada pradhanyam. Bhakti is there, but still, I think they have a lot of difficulty with God. And accepting God as someone who is greater than them and stuff like that. So, a lot of problems are there in the so-called Vedantins also. But anyway, so here, asambhedaya, that is why lokana asambhedaya, asambhinna mariyadaya. And so, he is the one who maintains all the boundaries so that the lokas. Lokas means the worlds and all the elements and everything that is in the world, all of them remain in that place and do what is required to be done. Because the importance is vyavastha. He says, suppose you God favors somebody when he doesn't deserve, then how can there be vyavastha? There will not be vyavastha. So nayayikas are committed to vyavastha. Otherwise there is no nyaya. What happens is nayayikas are committed to nyaya. Means the rule. And all the inference and everything works according to rule. You can't predict. The predictability always requires a rule. Otherwise you can't predict anything, you know. And so, that the water will boil at 100 degrees centigrade, that you can predict because the water follows a certain law. That's called nyaya. Nyayikas are those whose life depends upon nyaya. Whose life depends upon laws. And the vyavastha. If there is no vyavastha, there is no predictability, there is no science at all. So scientist can never accept miracles, can never, because then he cannot be a scientist. If he accepts it, then we have to, you know, put him in a different category. He cannot accept it. Because he is a nayayika, purely. And that being the case, there must be an order. A vyavastha must be there. If vyavastha has to be there, then this business of favoring, etc. cannot be there. You favor somebody and you don't favor somebody else, and you only, your bhaktas you favor, the other fellows are not your bhaktas and you just leave them hanging, then there is no vyavastha. And so, people who are wedded to vyavastha, vyavastha, vyavastha kya karte hain, bhai? Bhagavan ke rajya mein vyavastha kya? Bhakta, you know. So, in bhakti, when love comes, no vyavastha is there. When love comes, vyavastha goes away. And therefore, mother will embrace any child. Doesn't matter what the child is in. So, in Bible also, that's that parable is there, you know, of the son, what is it? The son returning, you know. The son left his father, the prodigal son, right. The prodigal son. Son is prodigal, but the father is not. And so, the son comes back to father. father is accepts him, you know, however he is. But then the Vedantin says, well, he came back anyway, and therefore, so, this is a very interesting debate, you know. So father received the son, prodigal son, but he came back, so that much affection. And so favor also has some expectation. What is the expectation? That the bhakta should do something. That's all right. So anyway, this is a very interesting debate, and depends on how you look at it. It's anirvachaniyam, by the way. That's the reason why the debate cannot be settled. Depends on how you look at it. And so, because the anirvachaniyam, you can have whatever position you want also, by the way. And therefore, nothing can be totally wrong, and nothing can be totally right also. So no vada, etc. can be absolute. Cannot be. Advaita is also all vadas. Means all of these are models. So everything is a model. But a model which the Acharya provides, supposedly because it explains everything according to them, or more things than other models, I guess, you know. But so, when love becomes the thing, when love becomes the truth, then the law cannot be there. When law becomes the truth, love cannot be there. And so, all Dharma Shastra is based on law. There is no love there. In Dharma Shastra, Vidhi and Nisheda, do's and don'ts, that's all. Do this and you get that, don't do that, that's it. So, in Hindu, in India, there is all Dharma and Dharma and Dharma. Everybody follows Dharma. Everybody follows righteousness. In righteousness, there is no love business, you know. So, all the Dharma fellows, they don't have much sensitivity. They all just follow the law. This is what Shruti says, therefore we do that. The people who are very sensitive are not very conscious about the law also sometimes, you know. So, sensitivity on one hand, law on the other hand, the Vedanta supposedly strikes a balance between all of this, you know. So being, abiding by the law, being sensitive also. So that being sensitive, so that law doesn't control you. And being abiding so that your sensitivity doesn't make you transgress something. So law should not become so rigid that becomes, you know, that there is no scope for any feelings, and feelings cannot become boundless that they do not follow any law. So this is how Vedantins will always strike a balance. Tatpada, Svampada. It's with this self-effort and grace and everything. So that is how Lokanam Asambhedaya Asambhinna Maryadaya, so that all these lokas retain their maryada. Tathacha Asambhedakatvena Vidharetrittvam Viti Bhavaha. So he is a Vidharaita, he is a boundary by maintaining, so keeping everything distinct in their appropriate places. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Kṛtau vande bhagavantau punah punah Īśvaro gururātmeri Mūrti bheda vibhāgine Vyomavat vyāpta dehāya Dakṣiṇāmūrtaye namah Om shanti 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 Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om
Mahanaja Atma Yoyam Vijnana Mayav Praneshu Eshontar Rudaya Akashah Tasmin Shete Sarvasya Vashi Sarvasya Shanah Sarvasya Adhipatihi सन साधुना कर्मणा भूया नो एवा साधुना कनीया एष सर्वेश्वरः एष भूताधिपतिः एष भूतपालः एष सेतुर्विधरणः येषां लोकानाम संभेदाय तमेतं वेदानुवचनेन ब्राह्मणा विविदिशन्ते यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा नाशकेन एतमेव विदित्वा मुनिर्भवति एतमेव प्रव्राजिनो लोकमिच्छन्तः प्रव्रजन्ते एतद्भस्म वै तत्पूर्वे विद्वांसः प्रजान्न कामयन्ते ईषणायाश्च लोकैषणायाश्च व्युत्थाय भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति या ह्येव पुत्रैषणा सा वित्तैषणा या वित्तैषणा सा लोकैषणा उभे ह्येते एषणे एव भवतः शेषनेति नैत्यात्मा अगृह्यो न हि गृह्यते अशीर्यो न हि शीर्यते असङ्गो न हि सज्जते असितो न व्यसते न रिष्यते एतमुहैवैतेन तरतैते अतः पापमकरोमिति अतः कल्याणमकरोमिति उभे उहै वैशेते तरते नैनं कृताकृते तपतः
योऽयं विज्ञानमेव प्राणेषु यथा व्याख्यातासेव एषोऽन्तर्हृदये हृदयपुण्डरीकमध्ये एष आकाशः बुद्धिविज्ञानसंशय तस्मिन् आकाशे बुद्धिविज्ञानशैलेशेते तिष्ठते
हौ दि परमात्मा ऑब्टेन्स इन द स्पेस ऑब्टेनिंग द हार्ट विच इज द सीट ऑफ द इंटेलेक्ट एंड दैट इज वेर ही गेट्स रिफ्लेक्टेड एंड दैट्स हाउ एज रिफ्लेक्टेड कॉन्शियसनेस वन कैन से और एज बुद्धियादि उपाधि सहित एज क्वालिफाइड बाय द उपाधि बुद्धि ही ऑब्टेन्स इन द स्पेस विद इन द हार्ट
अथवा संप्रसाद काले अंतर्दये एषाकाश परेवात्मा निरुपाधिको विज्ञानमयस्य स्वस्वरूपः स्वस्वभावः तस्मिन् स्वस्वभावे परमात्मनि आकाशाख्ये शेते
ओवन मे से दैट एट द टाइम ऑफ डीप स्लीप द जीवात्मा ऑब्टेन्स इन हिज ट्रू नेचर विच इज परमात्मा विच इज निरुपाधिकः डिवाइड ऑफ ऑल द उपाधिज विज्ञानमयस्य स्वस्वभावः which is the true nature of vijnanamaya atma, of jivatma, tasmin swasvabhave paramatmani akashakhye shete, this is jivatma obtains in paramatma, which is its true nature at the time of deep sleep, because all the upadhis have been dropped off except ignorance.
Chaturtha etad vyakhyadam kvesha tadabhut iti asya prativachanatvena.
This was already covered in the second chapter. In the Ajatashatru Brahmana, in the dialogue between Ajatashatru and Gargya. So this is the Anuvada. All this is Anuvada of what has gone by. Then begins the section, beginning with the result, the Atmajnana Phalam. So beginning from Sarvasya Vashi, so that tells us the phala, the result of the Atmajnana.
सह ब्रह्मी भूतो विज्ञानमय है
दैट जीवात्मा हु इज बिकम ब्रह्म ही इज सर्वस्य वशी ही बिकम्स अ वशी द कंट्रोलर ऑफ ऑल ब्रह्मेन्द्रादेह वशी ही बिकम्स अ कंट्रोलर सर्वस्य वशे वर्तते uktam cha etasya vaakshrasya prashasana iti. Inasmuch as he is identified with Brahman, which is immutable and which is described earlier as the one under whose mighty rule the entire creation functions, so one can say that on account of the identification Brahman, he also becomes Vashi, he also becomes the controller of everything and everyone. Na kevalam Vashi sarvasya ishanaha ishitacha. Not only the controller, but the lord of all. Brahmendra prabhutina ishitrattvam cha. Kadachit jyadikratam yatha rajakumarasya balavattaranapi bhrityan prati tadvadma bhutati. Sometimes one may think that the lordship is on account of his position, on account of his birth, just as a prince very often lords over the servants who are much more powerful than him. Not that way. He says, sarvasya adhipatihi, sarvasya palayita, svatantra, adhishthaya palayita. So he is a protector of all by controlling them. So sarvas adhishthaya. That adhishthana means under control. So adhishthaya, having controlled all of them, he is a palayita, he is the protector of them all. Na rajaputravat amatyadibhut bhrityatantra. Not that he is the one who can be controlled by ministers and things like that. Trapetat vashitvadehi hetu hetumadrupam yasmat sarvasya adhipadehi tata asau sarvasya ishanaha. He is in sarvasya adhipatihi, that's how it works. Sarvasya adhipatihi yasmat, tasmat sarvasya ishana, yasmat ishana, tasmat sarvasya vashi. Sarvasya vashi, kasmat sarvasya ishana, kasmat sarvasya adhipatihi. So he is the controller of all. Why is it so? Because he is the lord of all. Why is it so? Because he is the protector of all. Yasmat sarvasya adhipatihi tatah asau sarvasya ishanah. Since he is the adhipatihi, so he is the lord or the master of all, therefore he is the lord of all. Yoyam adhishthaya palayati. So adhipatihi adhishthaya palayati. So he protects them, he is the master of them, being controller of them. Satam pratishte vedi prasiddham. It's well known that he, the one who protects them by controlling them, he makes rules for them also. Yasmat sarvasya ishana tasmat sarvasya vashiti. And since he is the lord of all, therefore he is the controller of all. Kinchanyat sevam bhuto irudyandar jodhi purusha vijnanamaya na sadhuna shastra vite karuna bhuyan bhavati. I am reading all this because Vartikari will explain all of this, basically in the same way. And this Vijnanamaya, this Jivatma or Vijnanamaya, the self of the nature of consciousness, who obtains within the heart, na sadhuna shastra vitena karmana bhuyan bhavati. So, na sadhuna karmana bhuyan. He doesn't become increased, he doesn't become enhanced because of punya karma, because of virtuous deeds. Purvavastadaha kenachit dharmena. That by performance of dharma, a virtuous deed, he doesn't get increased or doesn't grow from his previous condition because he has reached a condition from where no further growth is possible. Noeva shastra pratishiddhena asadhuna karmana kaniyan alpataro bhavati. Nor by performing what we call the vicious deeds, that he becomes reduced in any way from his glory. Sarohi adhishthana palanadi kurvan paranugraha pridakratena dharma dharmakhyena vidyate asyaudu katham tadabhavayati. But we know very well that whenever somebody controls them, protects them and lords over them, then it becomes necessary for him to punish the persons who are guilty and reward those who are virtuous. So also this one, being the lord of all, would automatically wind up punishing the guilty and rewarding those who are virtuous. And therefore, he also will be stuck with the punya-papa as a result of that. Then how come everybody becomes affected by the punya-papa that they do, and this one does not? Uchade yasma desha sarveshwara. Again, because he is sarveshwara. Sarveshwara san karmanopi ishitam bhavati. See, he is the lord of all, that all also includes karma, and so he is the controller of karma and not controlled by karma. So bhavati eva shilamasya tasmān na karmana sambandhyate. So ordinarily everybody is controlled by karma, but he is the lord of karma itself, and therefore punya and papa karma cannot influence him. Kinchesh bhutadipatihi brahmadistama paryantanam bhutanam adhipatihi. And he is the adhipati duktar sampadam already. So esh sarveshva esh bhutadipatihi, because sarvasya adhipatihi anyway. So bhutadipati and sarvasya adhipati is not really different. Brahmadistam paryantanam bhutanam adhipati uktartham padam adhishthaya palayita. So ruling over them, controlling over them, prakritim swam adhishthaya sambhavamyatma maya. So wielding my prakriti, I take a form by my maya. So he wields this prakriti. So adhishthaya palayita, his wielding or ruling or controlling or mastering all of those whom he is protecting. Esha bhutanam teshameva palayita rakshita. Then bhutapalaha esha bhutapalaha. Same. So those whom he is protecting, those whom he is ruling, there is not much difference, patihi and palayita and so forth. So esha bhutanam teshameva palayita rakshita. So for the purpose of meaning, I guess you can give different meaning to all of them. That's what you can do. So Sarveshwara, Lord, Bhutadipati, ruler, and Bhutapala, protector. All right. Lord, ruler, protector. So Teshameya Bhutanam Palaita Rakshita. He is a very protector of all those beings over whom he is ruling. Esha Setuhu, we are on page 1279. Esha Setuhu, and he is a very Setuhu. So his embankment, he is a bank that serves as a boundary to keep the different worlds apart from each other, you know. So he is a very boundary which keeps, he is the very bank which acts as a boundary. Just as an ordinary embankment also serves a boundary to keep the bodies of water separate, or confining the body of water for the rest of the land. In short, that is called embankment, which maintains the distinction between different things. And so also he is a setuhu, he is embankment that maintains distinction between the different worlds. So let us read this. I think that is where we were actually. Esha setuhu kim vishishtah iti aha vitharanah varanashramadi vyavasthayah vidharaita tadah esham puradinam brahmalokantanam lokanam asambhedaya asambhinna maryadaya. Esha setuhu, so he is a very bank or embankment. Kim vishishta, so what's the nature of that setu, what's the nature of that bank? Ityaha vidharana, so vidharana is a boundary. So this is a bank which is a boundary. Varanashramadi vyavasthayah vidharaita. He is a boundary that holds this vyavastha, this very order of varanashrama. Adina bhuradi lokagraha. So vidharaita, one who keeps them all in the check. So including all the worlds, bhuhu, bhuvah, suvah, and different varanas and different ashramas, he is the one who maintains the separation or distinction between all of them. So that is why to say, tadaha esha setuhu vidharanah, Yesham lokanam asambhedaya. That's what the Shruti says. Yesham bhuradinam lokanam brahma lokantanam lokanam asambhedaya. So you see, vidharana, he's a boundary. The embankment that serves as a boundary for all these worlds, all the way up to brahma loka. Asambhedaya. Tathacha asambhedagatvena vidharaitrattvam iti bhavaha. Inasmuch as he maintains the distinction between all of them, that is how he is the vidharanaha, therefore he is the boundary. Asambhinna maryadaya. So that there is no, the maryada, the boundary is not transgressed, and he makes sure that nothing ever transgresses its boundary. Whatever mandate is given, everybody is given a mandate. Fire is given a mandate, sun is given a mandate, moon is given, everybody is given a mandate, every atom also is given a mandate. He makes sure that nobody ever crosses the mandate. Not only that, but everybody fulfills the mandate and nobody transgresses the mandate. Asambhinna maryadaya. Siddhanagiri tadeva sadhayati. So that is what Bhashyakara establishes. Parameshwaranidhi next says here. Parameshwarena setuvata abhidharyamana lokaha sambhinna maryada syuhu. Parameshwarena setuvat abhidharyamana lokaha. If loka are the worlds, all the different worlds. Worlds include every being, as a matter of fact. Every element in the creation, every atom also. Sidvat avidharyamanaha. If the Lord were not maintaining that distinction and keeping them separate, you know, being so preventing them from mixing up with each other. Avidharya Sethuvat, just as a Sethu or a bank, how it maintains the boundary between the different, you know, bodies of water, or between water and earth. Similarly also, if the Lord were not maintaining the boundary of all these distinct elements in the world, lokaha sambhinna maryada syuhu, then sometimes the fire may feel that, alright, why not today I cool down everybody instead of burning? And sun may feel that, alright, let me make the whole world dark and things like that. Sambhinna maryada. There, maryada, all their boundaries, all will be all transgressed. And that doesn't happen, of course. I mean, all of this is nothing but, it's not proof, all of this is a very solid evidence that there is God. That there is esha setuhu vidharanaha esham lokanam asambhedaya. That everything always functions according to its nature is not an accident. That is it is something that is predetermined, something that is intelligent. So not only there is an intelligence in every atom, but we also find that every atom is required to function according to its own maryada. That's also important. So intelligence is there, the rule is there, and then we find also every atom is taken care of. You see, the thing is that everybody is ruled, all right, but everybody is taken care of. So palaita. He is not only sarvasya ishita, sarvasya vashi, he is not only the controller of all, he lords over them, same time, adhishthaya palaita, he takes care of them, he protects also. So, normally the rule is such that you control them. When you control them, you become insensitive to them, you are sensitive to yourself. Because control also comes out of one's own need, you know. There is a need to control somebody in different ways. All of that also arises from my own need. Here the Lord appears to control everybody, but not out of his need, because in the very controlling he fulfills the needs of all. And if those were not controlled that way, if the maryada boundaries are not maintained, it would be for their own, disadvantage, or they themselves would be hurt. So sometimes people may not know the distinct difference between what we call the freedom and the license, and very often the license may be mistaken to be freedom. Except that when that license is there, then one hurts one's own self. Similarly also, the loka or the worlds, and all the different elements and everything in the creation. If it was left to themselves to maintain the road boundary, they may not. And they may transgress the boundaries in the process, hurt others and hurt themselves. Therefore, the reason to keep the boundaries is for their all well, for their own well-being, not out of his need. So idea is that the lordship and the rulership and all of this is not out of the need of the one who lords or rules, out of the need of those who are ruled. This is most important, because then alone it will work, otherwise it will not work. When you control somebody, when you rule somebody, whatever it is, you must be a palayita. He is not merely a ruler, but he is a protector. He is the one who takes care. And that is the intention of, in fact, controlling or ruling. In short, the leader must be one who must be as best as possible, totally selfless, totally non-demanding, and free from all needs. You can be non-demanding provided you are free from needs. And you are free from need. Needs are always emotional. There are no other needs in this world. All the food and stuff like that is a need that will provide. All needs are emotional. And therefore, only when one is emotionally grown, then alone one can really become a leader. Otherwise one cannot. He'll mess up everything. He may become leader out of some kind of thing that he has, you know, some kind of a charm or charisma or whatever he has, and therefore people may look up to him, but then he'll mess up everything if he's not free from his own needs. So therefore, here is the one who is totally free from every need. Because Atma Kamaha, so Apta Kamaha, Atma Kamaha. He's Apta Kamaha, when all those needs are fulfilled because of the knowledge that everything is Atma. And that being the case, he is totally free from needs, and whatever he does will automatically be done for the well-being of others, without even making an effort. That paropakara, what automatically will become his very nature. So going to page 1280.
अतः लोकानां असंभेदाय सेतुभूतोऽयं परमेश्वरः यः स्वयं ज्योतिरात्मा एव.
अतः फुट्नोट् नंबर 1. अतः अन्यदार्थमित्यादिना विधारयितृमन्तरस्य प्रत्युदस्तत्वादिति अर्थः. Atah, that's interesting, you know, this word atah is connected. Atah nyadartam from Chandogya Upanishad. Everything other than, if here also, in Brihadaranyaka also, in fact, atah nyadartam, everything other than this is artam perishable. Everything other than atma, everything other than truth is perishable, which means not there, as a matter of fact.
Ityadina vidharaitrantarasya.
Vidharetru antrasya pratyudastatvat. So that way, any other vidharaita, if there are more than one controllers or rulers, then also there's a problem. Suppose more than one person is trying to maintain the boundaries, then they will have their own whims of how to do that. Since there is no other vidharaita, there is no other ruler or controller or maintaining the boundary of the bank, therefore,
अतः लोकानाम असंभेदाय.
And therefore, preventing the mixing up of the worlds and mixing up everything. Most amazing, everything is distinct from everything. Even the two leaves are also, each leaf has its own identity. Everything has its own identity. Every atom, of course we don't know, but every DNA has its own identity. You know, every DNA has a certain code, I guess. And there must be billions of them. I'm sure that each one of them has something, you know, of its own. Whether it belongs to liver, it belongs to brain, it belongs everywhere. The cell has a different kind of a intelligence code built into that. Everything is unique. It's most amazing. What an amount of knowledge there must be. It is, the omniscience is evident everywhere. That everything enjoys a uniqueness. Even though everything enjoys a oneness, At the same time, it enjoys uniqueness. The uniqueness can be enjoyed provided the oneness is known. Otherwise, uniqueness becomes something that isolates me. So distinctiveness or uniqueness can become a cause of isolation if the inherent oneness is not appreciated. But anyway, even when there is an inherent oneness, then there is also at the same time a uniqueness in everything. Everything is unique. And so every fingerprint also is unique. It's most amazing that if a person can be identified with a fingerprint, that means that none of his other fingers has the same print, and that nobody's finger has this print, not only present but in the past also, and in future also it will not be so. Because in the past, with all the billions of people who came into being, if anyone had a fingerprint like that, then you cannot say for certain that it is this person. And all the billions of people who are going to come in future, if anyone will have that fingerprint. So what an amount of code must be there in the computer, you know, that nothing should be repeated. Not a single fingerprint should be repeated. That must be, in some way, every fingerprint must be noted in the computer. And that it doesn't get repeated, you know. This must be mind-boggling. You know, it is mind-boggling. But anyway, sa kasya stotavyah, kati vidha gunah, kasya vishayah, kati vidha gunah. Who can praise you? And so, who can describe you, who can praise you, how many gunas you have? Even Saraswati also cannot do that. Atah lokanam asambhedaya. And that's how maintaining the distinct characteristic or distinct nature of everything in the creation. Setu bhutoyam. Who does that? I am Parameshwara. This Lord, Setu bhutah. He is of the nature of that embankment that maintains the uniqueness and distinction of everything that is there in the creation. Who is he? Yes, Svayam Jyotihi Atma Eva. The Parameshwara is none other than Svayam Jyotir Atma, the Atma, the Self, that is self-effulgent, that was earlier described as a Jivatma. Sarvasya Vashityadana Uktam Upasamharati. And then all of this, Asambhedaya, all of this is Anuvada. So, Safalam Atmajnanam Anudya, it was said. Self-knowledge has been reiterated, recapitulated along with the phala, the result of the Atmajnanam. So, Anandagiri said, Sarvasya Vashityadana Uktam Upasamharati Evam Vedite. So, all of that has been said up to this point is now, beginning from Sarvasya Vashi up to this point. So, from Sarvasya Vashi up to Asambhedaya, Upasamharati Bhashyakara concludes that Evam Vita Sarvasya Vashi Ityadi Brahma Vidyayaha Phalam Etan Nirdishtam. Footnote number 2. Evam Vidati. Sava Esh Mahanada Ityadi Shrutya Anuditam Etat Adhyayuktam Brahmatmakyam Vastu Evam Shabdartha. Evam Vit. One who knows thus. Evam. Evam Vit Iti Evam Vit. One who knows Evam. What is Evam? Sava Esh Mahanada Ityadi Shrutya Anuditam Svayesha Mahanajatma Yom Vijnaname Praneshu Yeshuntarve Akasha Tasmin Shete Ityadi Shrutya Anuditam. So this is the Anuvada Shruti has made of the truth that has been revealed in the earlier chapters up to this point. Ida Dhyayuktam. And also, so all the will stayed in this Adhyaya. Not only this adhyaya, the second chapter also came. And so, etat adhyayoktam shrutya anuditam. So, whatever has been so far stated in this fourth chapter has been recapitulated by the Shruti in this statement. So, savayesha mahanajatma, etc. So, brahmatmekyam, which reveals the identity between saha and esha, where saha is the vijnanamaya atma, jivatma, esha is the mahanaja, paramatma. So, brahmatmaikyam, that identity between Brahma and Atma, evam shabdartha. That's the meaning of the word evam. So evam with, one knows the identity between jiva and Brahma.
Sarvasivashityadi Brahma Vidyayaha Phalametam Nirnishtam.
This is that he becomes the ruler, he becomes the controller, he becomes the Lord. All of that is the phala, that's the result of the Brahma Vidya. Let us put it this way, that had he been the Lord, and had he been the ruler, and had he been the controller of the entire universe, or if a person could be like that, how would he feel? This is what the wise person feels, that's all. And so, not that he physically becomes the controller or the ruler or what it is, but then, because in as much as controlling, ruling, all of these are the characteristics of the upadhi, at least from the standpoint of the onlookers, he is not, because his upadhi is limited and therefore he is not controller or ruler or anything. But then, that all of this is a description of freedom, that's what it is. All of this is a description of what we call freedom, that he enjoys the freedom, which is what one would enjoy had one been a controller and ruler and lord and so forth.
Phalametam nirnishtam, this is the phala of the Atma Jnanam that is indicated here by the Shruti.
Okay. So up to this point now, all the Bhashya up to this point pertaining to this, that is this Krodapatra, beginning from page 1203 or 1202 as a matter of fact, is it? Yeah. 1201 or 1200, what is it? Wow. 1269. All the way back there. 1269. And you have been given a handout, if you brought it with you, of course, then all of this is handout. Which tells you all this, gives you all this vartika along with the tika, so you don't have to go back and forth. That is why this is done for the convenience. Says here in page 1269, Savayesha Mahanityadi Asambhedayatyanta Upanishad Vakya Tad Bhashyantar Nihitathod Ghatakam Vartakavrindam Upanyasyade. Sava Esha Mahan, beginning from this, and Asambhedaya, ending up to Asambhedaya. Ityanta Upanishad Vakya, that's the passage of the Upanishad. Tad Bhashya, in the Bhashya of this passage, Tad Antarhita Arthod Ghatakam. So that which brings out the artha, the meaning, the tatparya of the Shruti as well as the Bhashya. Because sometimes Vartikara gives his explanations, you know, independently also. And sometimes he explains Bhashya also. Generally, the idea of the Vartika is to explain Bhashya, as a matter of fact. But then, sometimes Bhashyakara may be too brief, or sometimes Vartikara may see some other meaning also, which also he takes a liberty to give here. Arthodghatakam Vartika Vrindam Upanyasyade. And therefore the whole group of Vartika that brings out this meaning, Upanyasyade, is being presented here. Tatha aha. Nanudhyayat bahun shabdanadi kasmadiha uchyade alpiyasam. So, this is a verse 969 on the page 1236 of this handout. And 969 you can see in the line 26th, 26th line, you can see the explanation. Savayesha Mahanityadi Avatarayitum Chodayati. So Savayesha Mahanajatma Iti Avatarayitum. In order to introduce that, Chodayati questions here. So question is asked. Because earlier Vakya said, tamevam vidhiro vignaya prajnam kurvid brahmanah nanudhyayan bahun shabdan vacho viglapanam hi tat. So there Bhashyakara had said on the page 1268, tamidrusham atmanaiva dhiro dhiman vignaya upadeshadah shastrasya prajnam shastracharya upadishta visham jignyasa parisamapta karim kurvidam brahmanah. In short, brahmana must gain the knowledge and then must make his own. Evam prajnyakara sadhanani, that is all done. Then nanudhyayan bahun shabdan, nanudhyayan anuchandet bahun prabhurtan shabdan. Then one should not think of too many words. But then tatra bahutva pratishedat keval atmaikatva pratipadaka svalpa shabda anujnayante. Bahun shabdan anudhyayat, one should not think of too many words. That means a few words are allowed. What are those few words that are allowed? Kevala atmaikatva pratipadaka svalpaha shabdaha anujnayante. It is svalpaha shabdaha. Some shabda, some words which are atmaikatva pratipadaka. So those which delineate the identity of the Atma and Brahma, all those words are allowed. Shabda anujnayante. So by using the word bahun, Shruti in fact permits some words which are pertaining to the Atma and identity of Atma and Brahma. Om ityam dhayata atmanam anyavachayam jadaiti atharvane. Atmanam dhyayatha. We meditate upon Atma. So whatever is required to contemplate upon the Atma, to study the Atma, think about it, contemplate, all of that is fine. You do. Anyavacho vimunchatha. Anything that comes in the way of this, you give up. So that is what now Vartikara very brilliantly connects the previous passage with the next passage also. That is why Anandagiri said, Tikakara, Sava esha mahanityade avataretum chodayati. So in order to introduce this 22nd passage, he questions here, raises a question. Na ityadena. So the verse said, nanudhyayat bhavun shabdanidhi kasmadi havuchyate. Nanudhyayat bhavun shabdan. How come the previous passage said that one should not think of too many words? Why? Idi kasmadi havuchyate. Then the Tika says, mumukshuhu adhikari saptamyartha. How come iha means mumukshuhu? So mumukshuhu bhavun shabdan nanudhyayat. How come that mumukshu is said that he should not think of too many words? Kasma devuche chodai. This is chodana, this question. How come? Alpiyasam vanatyagah. And also, when it is said that too many words one should not think, that means that some words are permitted. Alpiyasam vanatyagah kasmadid abhidhiyatam. And how come those few words are not to be given up? Iti avidyatam. So may you tell us that. This is the question. That why too many words, thinking of too many words be given up? And how come thinking of some of the words must be retained also? Why is it so? Or what are those words, too many words, thinking of which is to be given up? And what are those limited words, thinking of which must be carried out? That also you should tell us. Then next verse. Now you see, you can tika, it's found on the same page, okay? You don't have to go back and forth. Otherwise, you have to go where? You must go to page 1270, the last line, and now page 1271.
Bahuni iti visheshanat alpiyasam tattvamadi shabdanam atyagah darshitah.
So bahu iti visheshanat, bahun shabdanna anudhyayet iti visheshanat, that too many words should not be dwelt upon. By that, alpiyasam tattvadi shabdanam atyagah darshitah. Shruti says that you should not give up the dwelling upon tattvamasi mahavakya, or whatever is required in order to dwell upon that, that should not be given up.
Tatra bhuvutsito hetuhu. So, bhuvutsito, bhuvutsa, bhuddhumiccha.
Earlier question, earlier words expressed a desire to know the reason.
Bhuvutsito hetuhu.
Because the question, then the question was there. So, kasmad eha uchyate, nan udhyayan, bahun shabdan, kasmad. So, kasmad means kasmad hetoho. What's the reason why the Shruti says that we should not think of too many words? And what's the reason why Shruti says that we should think of some words? That's the bhuvutsito hetuhu. In the previous verse, the hetu, the reason was, it was desired to know the reason.
So, bodhumishtaha hetuhu.
Then hetu, tametam ityataha praktanavakyena uchyate. So, that hetu, the reason why too many words should not be thought of, that reason is given by the passage of this passage, 22nd passage, up to tametam vedanam, up to asambhedaya. So, bhuvutsito hetuhu. Tametam ityataha praktana vakyena uchyate. So, the vakya, the passage, before this tametam, so up to asambhedaya, that tells us a hetu as to why too many words should not be thought about. So that's what the next verse is. It says, vairagya hetuhu vidishotpattihi. That's an advantage you have. So it says, now this section is vairagya hetuhu vidisha utpattihi. When vidisha utpatti takes place, so when vidisha or vedamicha, when jignasa arises, so vairagya hetuhu vedatyaga, so not vairagya, vedatyaga. How come you should give up the Vedas also? Karma kanda you should have given up? Vividisha utpattihi. Because vividisha, the desire to know has arisen, therefore you now give up all the other things. All Sri the Veda and karma kanda and all of this, you must give up now. And so the verse is, shabdasya, shabdasya alpiyaso tyage, tatra tavadiho chare, hitustrayasta santyage, tametamiti vakshate. Shabdasya alpiyasa atyage. Alpiyasa shabdasya atyage. The alpiyas, the limited, those few words should not be given up. Atyage tatra tavat iha uchyate hetuhu. Then all this is, esha mahanajatma tells us why the alpiyasa, the few words, should not be given up. So tatra tyagat tyagayoho iti yavat. So tyagat tyagayoho madhye. So tyaga, something is to be given up and something is not to be given up among them. Atyage. So that which is to be not given, what is it? The few words that are not to be given up. What's the hetuhu? Hetuhu. Tavad iha uchyate. Sava esha mahanaja atma, all of that is the reason why we should not give up those few words. That is what the Tika says. Sava esha ityadav atmayathatmam anudyate. Sava esha mahanaja atma atmayathatmam, the true nature of atma is being reiterated. Tena tadvishaya upanishad bhagena bhavitavyam. The fact that the 22nd passage takes the trouble to reiterate or restate the true nature of Atma, that means Upanishad is repeating the words. You see, the thing is that we are told not to repeat too many words. That means that we are permitted to repeat a few words. And then Upanishad repeats those words. The thing is, 22nd passage itself repeats those words, telling us that these are the words that you should repeat. These are the words that you should think about. And it will give up those other words, telling us that you should give up those words also. This is how Vartikara connects the 21st and 22nd passages. See, Bhashyakara doesn't mention this, but Vartikara mentions this. एष इत्यादौ आत्मयथात्वम् अनुद्यते तेन तद्विषय उपनिषद भागेन भवितव्यम्। सो ऑफ द होल वेदास उपनिषद इज अ भाग, उपनिषद सेक्शन विच गिव्स दी आत्मयाथात्म्यम, विच गिव्स दी ट्रू नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा, एंड देयरफॉर भवितव्यम दैट वन मस्ट मेंटेन। व्हाई इज इट सो? तस्याभित्याये तत्वज्ञान असिद्धेः। Because if you give up everything, the whole Veda is given up, including Upanishad, then tattva jnana asiddehe, the very tattva jnana will not take place, cannot be accomplished. Idi ityetat. Why do you say that? Tametam ityadi asmat prak abhipretam ityartha. So that's the idea. The reason why Upanishad itself repeats those words is to tell us that unless you repeat these words, unless you think about anubhyaya, so unless you dwell upon those words, even atma-jnanam, self-knowledge cannot take place. And therefore, Upanishad, in short, one must keep on thinking about Upanishads. That's the idea. Some people interpret this passage saying, thank God. Shastra, chodi do. Give up all the shastras and things like that. There is also people say. But that's not the intention. Shastra means all unnecessary things must be given up. That means there must be a total vairagya that you must give up everything other than what is that. So you must be single track mind.